Welcome to round four of the Parenting Roundabout podcast for the week of September 16th. I'm Catherine Maleko, and I'm here with Nicole Aridix.
Hello.
And Terry Morrow.
Hello.
As moms of teens and young adults, we've survived those little kid days, yet we're still rethinking the decisions we've made all through our kids' lives and worrying about what's going on right now. Today's Thursday, which means it's time to give in to our obsessing about parenting details, big and small, like how to handle all the stress that our children cause us, no matter their age.
Or proximity.
Exactly, or proximity. So we're going to talk a little bit about what keeps you going when you're in a stressful moment, or year, or decade, or whatever it is. Nicole, what have you found that works, if anything, for you?
If anything, that's the problem.
Well, and it's what works for you, right? Because what works for one person does not always work
right.
for another.
I find that sometimes, you know, when people say, oh, you should get out more and, you know, go visit with your friends and stuff. Sometimes I find that more stressful because all I want to do is just be at home, right?
Mm-hmm.
And kind of just lying in my bed.
Or when people tell you to take walks and eat vegetables, like, that is not helpful.
Exactly. Exactly. But in times of stress, I find eating helpful. My husband is often a good listener. He'll listen. I turn to him often. Napping.
So
I can forget about my problems.
Always a good solution.
Playing an online game distracts me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know. Some people go for a walk. I'm not really a walking kind of person, so that would cause me more anxiety if I had to go for a walk and I was stressed. What about you guys? What happens with you?
I take walks and eat vegetables.
See, I can't relate.
Yeah, I take walks too.
How does that de-stress you though?
Oh, it feels good. It's just to get out and get moving. Either I go with my husband and we chat. Well, I chat and he walks stoically, but or else I listen to podcasts as I walk. Get out in the air. I mean, we're just getting into good walking season here in New Jersey. I can't walk in the summer anymore because the humidity, I can't get enough oxygen in my body, and I have to sit down every so often and put my head between my legs, which is not low stress.
No.
So, but once the air
feeling
gets a little...
Feeling like you can't breathe is
Yes,
is
that
not
is a... that is stressful.
Yeah.
So that is works against it. But on a nice, cool, crisp day, taking a walk around, I really enjoy it. It is generally stress relieving, and I can't do anything. You know, I can't multitask. I can multitask and then I can listen to podcasts while I walk, but I can't, you know, use a computer. I can't be typing on something. Well, I suppose I could on my phone if I wanted to, but anyway, I don't. I listen most of the time.
Right.
If I feel a text in my pocket, maybe I take it out. Anyway.
But see, when I walk, I feel anxious about, okay, where am I going and how long is it going to take me and am I going to get robbed?
Well, I do exactly the same walk every time, so that problem is not present. We have this high school next door and I just walk around the high school twice and that's about a mile.
So
it's fairly
track,
boring
so
and traditional. Every now and then you see somebody with their dog and, you know, greet them, but there's not a lot of thought about where you're going.
I have a couple basic laps that I
yes
routes
that's exactly
that I take.
What it is,
and sometimes I get sick of those though and I need to mix it up, but I don't like to drive somewhere just to walk.
That's true. I'm very lucky that there are walking places right outside my door, because I would not drive someplace to walk.
I certainly can and do walk by just walking out my door, but but if I want to mix things up, actually our high school has a good set of paths around it as well. So often earlier in the summer, the late summer when my son had to be going to the school all the time for rehearsals, I would, you know, park and walk.
That works out well.
There. Yeah. So
my son does softball at a place that has paths, and that's really nice. I always try to go, and, you know, while he does his thing, I walk around.
Right.
That's very
pleasant. Because, you know, multitasking in that way is satisfying to me.
Yeah.
You know, like.
That's true.
And not that it's necessarily beats stress, I guess, but it just.
Yeah.
It's, like I said, it's satisfying.
Yeah. And, I don't know.
I am so opposite.
Have you ever tried meditation, Nicole? Can you, like, sit and breathe deeply? Breathing deeply is helpful to me, stress-wise.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have. I find, like, I need to do two things. Is I need to, like, hunker down, and mm-hmm. I don't know what that is, if it's, like, a security thing, or if it's, like, you know, if I stay still, nothing bad is going to happen. Uh-huh. And then I need to distract myself, like, with... Yeah. You know, either by finding an answer or researching it or playing a game online. Or, like, I can't, like, if I sit and dwell on it, it just obviously makes it worse.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
And then, yeah, I don't know. Maybe that's more of a panic attack. I don't know.
Yikes.
But. Well, if I get stressed because I feel like I have too much to do, mm-hmm. Then I find that if I, like, sort of write everything down, like, okay, this is what has to be done. And then I can feel like I can wrap my head around it a little better.
Yeah. There's a, there's an online thing. I think it's called, is it Trello? Mm-hmm. Where you can make lists and then move items around between lists. Let me just make sure that's what I'm talking about. And I made up, like, different levels of emergency worry, you know, like, you know, code red, I have to deal with this right now, and then sort of nagging thoughts and, you know, just smaller concerns, so that anytime I'm, like, worrying or obsessing about something, I do that, and, you know,
you
I go on
it
there,
against your list of-
and I delete things, and then I have, like, a list that says, woohoo! You took care of it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's been really helpful. Mm-hmm. I've really liked that. Otherwise, just writing things down, making checkoff lists, writing things in a date book or on a piece of paper, just so it's, like, downloaded out of my head.
Yeah.
Because I, you know, am getting to that age where my memory's not as great as it was. And so I have a constant low-level panic that I'm forgetting something. Mm-hmm. So I figure if I make these lists and I write stuff down and I tell other people where they are in case mm-hmm. something happens to me and they need to deal with it, then I don't have to hold on to every single thing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is indeed Trello. I have here Terry's Worry Board. And it's minor nagging, major head exploding, and completed you rock are my categories.
Ah.
So, Are there a lot of things on the head exploding one?
There are not at this time, but there were.
Good.
And I have used this as a tool to move them, you know, out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
But maybe some of these nagging ones probably should, like, be making their way over as they've been nagging for a long time. I'm looking at the things that are in the minor and nagging, and they've just been abandoned there pretty much. But
well, that maybe that means that they aren't a problem.
They aren't that important.
Right.
Yes. Yes. I also have tried, like, for a while I was having some success making a top 10 list every day of little things that I was going to get done over and above work, over and above any obvious stuff, you know, like answer, and, you know, I could, like, one email would be one item. So if I do mm-hmm. five emails, that's five things. Just things that I'm afraid I'm going to forget to do, or that I'm going to put off making a doctor's appointment I've been putting off, I'll put it on there to kind of make sure that I have to do it. Although sometimes I would play around with it. But yeah, just anything that, like, downloads it out of my head is helpful, I think.
I use my calendar for that. Like, mm-hmm. I decide, okay, on this day I'm going to contact this person about whatever. And so then I write it down, and then I get to cross it out once I've done it. Mm-hmm. But if I don't do it, I can just move it to the next day.
Right. Right. That's nice. But it's at least gives you some, it's like the tracking with Weight Watchers. It gives you some accountability. You have something that's saying, did you do this yet? Huh? Huh? Huh?
Mm-hmm. Right. And it's good for things that, you know, you don't have to do right this second, but if you thought about it, then you can write it down and now you don't have to think about it again until it appears on that day.
As long as you don't find lists stressful,
then
you're not helping.
Right.
True. Now I'm getting all stressed just talking about stress.
Yeah. Does prayer help you with stress at all? Tiptoeing into a delicate topic. I find sometimes saying a rosary is helpful, just because it's a rote recitation of prayers that I don't really have to think, you know, other than just to kind of be present in the moment. I like doing that.
I found it helpful at certain times in my life, but it's not something, it's not a fallback.
Yeah.
It's not. It used to be, but, you know, things have evolved in my line of thinking. It's not my fallback position anymore, but.
I think it is a way to kind of channel what you're worrying about into something you feel like you did something.
Yes, that's the way I feel about it too. If there's stuff that there's really nothing you can do, you feel like you're, you know, being effective. And of course, that's only helpful if you believe, but, you know, if you do, it's an option. And if you have different beliefs, there's tons and tons of meditation stuff out there that's taking that same sort of idea and putting it on a more general footing.
Exactly.
So that can be very soothing, just to, you know, kind of bring your head into just paying attention to what's going on in the moment. 'Cause what's going on all around you is sort of, almost all
and
the time.
And I have to be honest and say, sometimes I'm not adverse to medication, so I'll just leave that out there as well.
Yes, that is an option that many people find comforting.
Yes, it is. I mean, sometimes
and necessary.
I would be stressing about side effects, but I suppose maybe or does it keep you from stressing
because
about
it wouldn't
side
make
effects?
You feel stressed.
Does it turn that knob off?
It turns it right off.
That would be comforting.
You wouldn't be worrying about that stuff, Terry.
I'm pretty sure there is no off switch in my head. And just looking at my family history, I think that it's in permanent on position. There is no off.
Thanks, Mom.
Exactly. Well, we hope whoever's listening to this has their ways of coping with stress that are helpful to them and are not struggling too much to find relief.
Yeah.
So we'll stop talking about the topic of stress because it's stressing me out. And that's it for today's round four. Tune in tomorrow when we'll share our roundabout roundup of things we've been using or enjoying lately that we think deserve a shout out. Find all our episodes on parentingroundabout.com and talk back in the comments there, on our Facebook page, or on Twitter, where you'll find us at Roundabout Chat.